We're saving turtles. Hi friends, hello, hi, how are you? I hope you guys are having an amazing day today. So today, I got my hair cut like a tiny bit. It felt like it was like 27 inches getting taken off, but it wasn't. It was like half an inch. But I can finally do my poof again and not have it be as outrageous as it once was. So that's very exciting for me. Second order of business, we are taking a break from commentary videos for like one day. I've made a ton of them, way more than I normally do. I like to usually space them out a little bit because I just don't want to like bombard the timeline. Like, you guys didn't necessarily subscribe just for commentary stuff. So I did want to break that up a little bit. So instead of like a full-on commentary video, we are just gonna be trashing some makeup.
My favorite pastime.
So today I want to talk about makeup that I personally think is overhyped. I don't do disclaimers. However, if you love this stuff, I don't care. Like, I don't care. It didn't work for me. I'm so happy it worked for you and you didn't waste your money. That's that on that. Like, don't, people always leave hate comments on stuff like this because a product I talked about worked for them and they get personally offended by it. Just don't, okay? So today we're gonna be talking about makeup that I personally think is incredibly overhyped. I had the idea to do this video in one of my like previous makeup videos. I just randomly had the idea to do it and I wanted to follow through on it. So we are gonna be talking about makeup that I find to be overhyped. I said that 5 times now. Before we get into this, I did launch this on Twitter and Instagram, but I have launched limited edition exclusive spooky glow merchandise. It comes in 4 different fall themed colors. I believe black, purple, like a dark green, and orange. So it comes in 4 colors. I have hoodies, t-shirts, long sleeve shirts, and I'm adding mugs. And all of the proceeds for all of my merch for the month of October will be going to St. Jude's Children's Research Hospital. It's like a really good organization that I really, really like. So I wanted to donate to it. I thought it'd be really cute for you guys. Shout out if you're interested. And it's for all of the merch. You don't have to buy the spooky glow. If you've been wanting like the headband merch or anything else, all of the proceeds for all of the merch will be donated this month. So I'm really excited about that. If spooky season is like not your season, we're gonna be doing this again for Glowmas in December. So I don't want you to feel like this is the only chance you'll get to get like limited edition stuff or stuff that's gonna be donated. We're doing it again in December. So with that being said, let's jump right into the video and talk about makeup that I think is overhyped. This is product numero uno. This product, I was bamboozled so hard with this stuff. And the thing is, if you had asked me like 2 years ago if I thought Tarte Shape Tape was overhyped, I would have been like,
no, it's the best concealer. Every single, and Jaclyn Hill uses it.
Every single influencer ever uses it. Like, it's the best concealer on the planet. Truth be told, this concealer never truly worked for me. It's very full coverage, which is not really that big of an issue because a lot of stuff is full coverage, but it's so full coverage that if you put on too much, it just gets very creasy and very bad. I've actually found the more that I use this, the more I don't like it. Like, honestly. And it's expensive. It's like $30. It's very creasy. It's very thick. It looks very cakey on the under eyes, in my personal opinion, on my skin. And this is not something that I understand. I think the reason that influencers liked this so much is because it does make your skin look very airbrushed on camera or in photos, but normal everyday people don't put on makeup only to sit in front of a camera. So if I would try to wear this to like class or anything, I would just look ridiculous. Like, I felt like every time I wore this concealer, I looked creasy, I looked cakey, and I looked ridiculous. So this one is definitely, when I think overhyped, I think Tarte Shape Tape, because this was like a wave for like 2 years. Everyone was just obsessed with this concealer, and I'm glad we're moving on to things that are maybe a little bit lighter coverage, maybe less of a thick formula. I really like the Makeup Forever Ultra HD concealer. That's been like my go-to lately because it's just a lighter coverage. It's a lighter formula. It doesn't look cakey. It doesn't get in my creases. Like, this is just too much. This is the Hourglass Vanish foundation, and I know some of you are screaming in horror because I know a lot of you love this foundation stick, and that's why I bought it. I asked, I said, is the Hourglass foundation stick overhyped? And you guys said no. You guys said it was amazing. You guys said, even though the price per gram is absolutely ridiculous, even though it's like super expensive and you get like literally no product. What is it? 0.25 ounces, which is bad. It's amazing. It's legend. It'll change your life. And at first, I think I wanted to, but a lot of these are ones that I used to really like because I think I wanted to, this is literally after I've like used this a couple of times and this is how much is left. I wanted to believe that this wasn't wasted money. I wanted to believe all of the hype around it. I wanted it to change my life. I wanted it to be this like holy grail foundation stick that everyone claimed it to be. And to be just perfectly honest with you, it's just not. I think if this was maybe a cheaper foundation or if you got a ton more product so it made it worth the money you were paying, I don't think I would be as critical of it. But for the price you're paying and the product you're getting, it's not good. It is not worth the price per ounce. And it's also not even that amazing of a foundation. Like, it's okay. It's fun. I'll use it. Like, I'll definitely finish this and it won't take me long because there's no product. Like, I'll finish this and I'll get use out of it. But at the same time, like, will I ever rebuy this? No. Do I feel a little duped by people who raved so heavily about this? Yes. Definitely not this like seamless, vanished, no foundation foundation look that everyone seems to claim. And again, maybe it's just my skin. Foundations are super, super particular. So it could just be my skin type. But for whatever reason, like it just doesn't give me that effect. If you want a decent foundation stick for a lot cheaper, the Milani Conceal and Perfect foundation stick, this one I really, really like. This is very good. And it's got, let's see how much product this has. It's like $10. This has 0.46 ounces, so it's almost double this one, and I think this was like $9. So if you're interested in a foundation stick that is like affordable, this is a really good option. A lot of these I realized as I was picking them, I was like, a lot of these are just expensive products. I feel like when it's an expensive product, you like better be worth the hype because I've now dropped some major coin on you. And if you're not worth the hype, I'm gonna be 10 times more I am like 10 times more nitpicky about expensive products, but I don't think that's a bad thing. I think we should be holding like more expensive products to a higher standard because you're spending way more money on this stuff. YSL Tucci Clot Blur Primer. I can't lie. When I, again, this is another one, when I first bought it, if you had asked me when I first bought it forever ago, I would have told you this was the best high-end foundation ever. Like, you can't be amazing. It really doesn't do anything except make your face kind of sparkly. Like, the more I use this, and I've used about probably almost half, and I'm gonna finish this. We're getting our money's worth out of this bad boy. It's not bad. It's like all the other things. It's not bad. It's just way overhyped. I feel like all the beauty gurus were like,
I know it's $60, but like, it's worth it.
And I'm here to tell you it's not. Like, this is not worth $60. This is not worth $40. I would even wager it's not worth $20. This is really worth like $10 because all it does is give you a little bit of a glow. Have you heard of strobing creams? Have you heard of like luminizing primers? Like, that's what this does. It's just too expensive and too raved about. And I tried to like it, but at the end of the day, it really does just give you, it doesn't smooth. It doesn't really like vitalize. It doesn't really improve your skin all that much. I think especially now, I know people are gonna hate me for saying this, but especially now that I am getting a little bit older and my skin is changing, because I turned 24 this year, my skin is definitely changing as I get a little bit older. I find I need things that actually do something. I can't rely on my little like 20-year-old skin to just like look okay despite treating it like crap. Like, I can't rely on those things anymore. I need the products that are gonna work. This is not a product that I feel works, and I just don't understand the hype of it. Like, I bought the Tatcha Silk Canvas. That's a product I believe in. Like, that's a product I can get behind. That's a product that I think is worth it because it does so much for your skin. This just doesn't do enough for your skin to be worth it, and I feel like everyone lied to me. So that's how I feel. This one I feel like Jaclyn Hill lied to me, which I know isn't like a new concept for a lot of people, but I bought this specifically because of Jaclyn Hill. Jaclyn Hill raved about this Lancome Absolute Powder. She raved. She has talked about it, and it wasn't even like a quick rave, like, oh, she's doing this for a commission code. It was like for a long time, she continually said this, and there's like a Charlotte Tilbury pressed powder that she just absolutely adores and loves, and credits her amazing looking skin to these products, right? And so I got it. I bought into the hype. I got it. Like, I was like, okay, mine, like, got it. It just isn't that, it doesn't, it's a powder. It's like any of the other powders I have in my collection. It's not that good. And again, this isn't even one where I was like, oh, I desperately want it to be worth the hype. I tried it for the first time and I was just like, this is $60 for a pressed powder. Like, that's my security bill for the month in a pressed powder, okay? It's ridiculous how much this costs for being so subpar. And it's like fine. It gives an interesting amount of coverage. Like it's kind of an interesting powder because it gives a tiny, tiny bit of coverage along with the powder, which I do think is kind of cool and I appreciate. But like my Fenty powder does that. My Anastasia powder does that. Like check and check, they're half the price of this. If you're gonna splurge, I'm telling you right now, if you're gonna splurge on makeup and you're gonna splurge on something like crazy luxurious, don't buy a powder. It's boring. Powders are boring. If you're gonna splurge on some crazy expensive piece of makeup, splurge on like a blush or an eyeshadow palette or a highlighter or something that you're gonna use every day and you're gonna be excited to use. I don't know about you guys, powders really don't excite me. Powder is probably one of the most boring parts of my makeup step because I blend it in and then it's gone. And then that's it. With like eyeshadow, there's so many different options. It's so creative. Like highlighters, it's so fun to like put on the glow and like all of these different things. Powder is boring. Don't spend $1 million on powder like this, especially this particular powder. It's so not good. This actually though gave me, I'm kind of glad that this bit me in the butt because I was actually debating, I wasn't debating, it crossed my mind, which is shameful enough to say, but it crossed my mind a couple times to maybe get the La Mer, that like $100 powder that Tati uses that she is like obsessed with. I like was kind of like, should I ever, maybe like for a gift to my, no, I'm not doing it. I'm not spending this much money on powder. It's absolutely not worth it. I don't think any powder would be worth this much money, and this one in particular especially is not, so no. There's a lot of Anastasia stuff in here which breaks my heart, but it's the true tea. This is their loose highlighter in So Hollywood. I don't even know if this would fall into the category of overhyped because I don't know how many people were hyping it up that weren't sent this for free for being on the ABH PR list. They have so many people on their PR list now, it's hard for me to tell who buys their stuff and who, and this isn't shade, but it is. It's hard for me to tell when I'm scrolling through my feed who bought the stuff and who was sent it through PR. But I know I did see a lot of people on Twitter specifically raving about this and raving about these loose highlighters. It's just buy the Juvia's Place one. Juvia's Place has loose, and I know Juvia's Place has their issues and whatnot. Their loose highlighter, they have a shade very similar to this shade, which is So Hollywood, the gold shade. And it's half the price and it's so good. It's so good. It's blinding. It's beautiful. This is just like, I guess I would call it like sparkle dust, but not in a good way. I like highlighters to be sparkly in the sense that they're very like sparkly and glowy. This is kind of just sparkle without any sort of glow. It's kind of like putting a satin, if you were had like a satin eyeshadow, like you know those eyeshadows that have just like a little bit of shimmer to them, and you, if you were to use that as a highlighter, that's what this would be. It just isn't that good. Yeah, like even right now I just put it on my arm and it is just so, I don't even know if you can see it on camera, like I don't even know if the camera's picking it up, but it's just so lackluster. And it's disappointing because I was so excited when I saw that this was gonna come out because I had wanted the So Hollywood like pressed single for so long because so many people, I have like FOMO about it because so many people have said it's so good, they wish it would come back, like whatnot. And so I was excited when I saw this because I thought maybe it would be that in like a pressed version, and it's just like, I don't know. I don't know if maybe it looks like amazing under the lights, but in person, it just doesn't do anything for me. Going off of that, I've talked about this before, but I'll say it again. These glow kits are BS. They're not good for me. I don't know what it is. I don't like them. They don't have any glow to them. They don't have any lasting power. They have nothing. Like, and it's these specific ones. Like, I like my Aurora Glow Kit, my Moonchild Glow Kit, and my, what's the other one? The Dream, yeah. I like my more like rectangular glow kits for some reason. Those ones are like so good and such a beautiful formula and such cool colors and like fantastic payoff. I don't know why that doesn't translate to these more neutral ones, but for whatever reason, the neutral glow kits do nothing for me. They don't give me a glow. They don't have like a long lasting power. And like you can barely see it when I put them on, I feel like. And it's so disappointing, particularly this glow kit, the Sun Dip one, the sugar one, there's like one shade in here, I think it's Butterscotch, that's actually like good and like works for me and I enjoy it. But this other one, there's nothing, like there's nothing I like about this. At one point I like found that if I sprayed my brush and I used it, I like sprayed the brush with setting spray and I used that. It definitely helps the glow effect, like it looks more glowy, but the staying power still sucks. Like even if I can make it look glowy by doing certain tricks, which I don't like having to do anyway, because I have enough highlighters that I don't have to spray with a setting spray brush to get to work, that I don't really like to have to do that for these. But like I can at least get some of the glow. However, the staying power is trash. So the highlight's gone in like an hour. So I guess we'll talk about this. This is gonna be controversial, I feel like, but it's just how I feel. This is the ABH Norvina Volume 1 palette. She has recently come out with two more volumes and another palette with Carly Bible. I miss the old Anastasia. This is what she looks like. It's a cool color selection. I think, to be perfectly honest, these Norvina palettes are being way too hyped up. And I did my review on this in like a Talktorial Tuesday, and I kind of gave you guys my opinion about this. I don't hate this palette. I'll get use out of it, and like, it's fine. But when I paid $60 for this palette, I did that because I wanted these colors in the ABH formula, and they're just not. I feel like what makes ABH so iconic and so cool to me and so worth like standing is their formula. Their formula is very unique. It's very, I just hit myself. Very unique. Their formula is very good. I enjoy their formula a lot. This just doesn't have it. It doesn't have that formula. It's a fine formula. It reminds me a lot of Huda Beauty's formula because it's very stiff. I don't mind her formula, but I didn't pay $60 for Huda's formula for this palette. I paid so I could get Anastasia's like formula in this palette. So I think for me, that's the biggest reason these are overhyped, is because it's not the actual ABH formula, which, to be perfectly honest, is what made the brand so famous and so popular, was their formula being more soft press, being very hyper pigmented, easy to blend. Like those are the things that made their brand famous, in my opinion. And this does not have that. I still don't mind it, but like it doesn't have that. And for me, that makes this way too overhyped because it just doesn't have the formula that I love. That's simple as that. Okay, this is the Natasha Denona Sunset palette. I personally believe most palettes like in the Pat McGrath and Natasha Denona price point are overhyped. I do own 2 Pat McGraths and 3 Natasha Denonas. To be honest with you guys, I like them. They're good, but I wouldn't recommend them, that like you need to have them. I feel like when the Natasha Denona Sunset palette came out, this was the first palette from her that came out that I saw on whose channel? I think it was Manny MUA's channel at the time. I saw this on his channel and I thought like, I need that. And he told me, you need this. Like you need this $129 eyeshadow palette. Like he convinced me at the time that this was worth the price. And a lot of people did. I saw a ton of people using the palette when it first came out, because everyone was like, it's, the formula is so revolutionary, it's so incredible, it's so different from anything else, like that's why you should buy this. And I don't feel that way. I didn't when I first bought it, and I have not felt that way since owning it. I have never once used this palette and been like, I couldn't create this look with the ColourPop Yes Please palette. Never. I've always felt like this was a dupable palette that wasn't that special, that was incredibly overpriced. I do, however, now feel that way about Pat McGrath. I feel like Pat McGrath shadows, I don't feel, are overhyped. I feel like the shimmer formula is unreal. It is unique. Nothing about these two gold shimmers, while they are pretty, nothing about them is unique. Nothing. I could find other gold shimmers like this. Are they nice to work with and pleasant to work with? Yes. Are the mattes easy to blend? Yes. Is it a bad palette? No. But do you need to pay $129 for it? Absolutely not. Never. I did actually enjoy her Sunset palette, the kind of sister palette to this one, that retailed for $65. And I hope that Natasha Denona continues to come out with things like that, that are at a lower price point, because I could just never sit here and tell you that this was worth the money. And I can't believe so many influencers felt so comfortable doing that. I can't believe so many influencers feel comfortable saying, yes, this is worth $129, when I just like, I can't understand how that's possible. So this one I hate. So this, I'm sorry, I hate this. This is the Charlotte Tilbury Filmstar Bronze and Glow palette. Oh, is this a scam? It's $70.
70.
And so many people, I watched hundreds of declutters and makeup collection videos where people had this stupid little palette and they were like, I could never get rid of this. It's my holy grail. It's the best thing I've ever used. you. I love it. Like,
they're liars.
They're all liars. They're dirty liars. This is not that good. It's okay. It's okay. My e.l.f. bronzer duo is better than this. Like, this is just okay. The only reason you're paying $70 is for the Charlotte Tilbury logo and the pretty packaging. Nothing about this is special. And this highlighter, which is supposed to be like a highlighter, like an actual shimmery, it's so chalky and so weird. It's such a weird texture and a weird like formula. It's so strange. This contour is like fine. It's okay. It works. So do the hundreds of other contours I own that aren't $70. Like, I just can't get over the price on this one. And I can't believe so many people have called this their holy grail. What? What have you been doing that made this your holy grail? Like, I don't understand what is so special about this to people that makes this a holy grail product for them. I don't get it. It's lost on me. Absolutely not. Like, don't buy this. Don't waste your money. Everything I've tried from Charlotte Tilbury, I would tell you to not waste your money on. And that's just how I feel about that. I hate these because I feel like my friends lied to me. I have a few friends here on YouTube who just love, grabbed all of the ones I own. The ColourPop So Juicy glosses. I don't like them. I'm getting progressively more and more angry. These aren't even that expensive. They're like $6. These are so not good at all. They have a horrible, horrible plumping taste to them. They don't plump anything, okay? My lips are so small that I feel like even the slightest of plumping effect, I would notice a difference. Not the tea. They just taste really bad. Don't actually plump anything. That's how I feel about that. The colors are like okay. More I hate the packaging on these because the squeezy tube, even though it's very reminiscent of like the early tooth that whatever, like I get it. It brings you back to like your childhood, like whatever. It's bad. Like you can't, they get these weird little clumps of places where the lip gloss is like separating and you can't do anything about it. You can't like fix it. You can like shake it, but it doesn't really move it around. And where with like a wand, you can like mix everything back up. You can't do that with these. They just start separating and there's nothing you can do about it. I talked about this in a different video. I think it was about packaging I hate, but I'm here to be petty today, so let's do it. Also, you can't control how much product you're actually pushing out of the tube at one time. Like you can't control how much product is going on your lips. And maybe if you have big lips, I wouldn't know that pleasure, but maybe if you had big lips and you could actually like, didn't matter if you had a little extra, like that would be fine for you. For me, with my tiny little lips that just kind of chill over here, if I put on too much, I look ridiculous. This also doesn't give me a very glossy finish, which I know sounds strange, but I think when you have smaller lips, you kind of like need a certain type of sheen for lip gloss to not look absolutely stupid. The best sheen I have found so far is from the Clarins lip oils. They provide just a perfect amount of sheen and gloss without being kind of goopy and gross like these ones. And I'm sorry, but that's just how I feel about that. Nisa, you lied to me. I have calling out Nisa particularly because I feel like she's the queen of lip gloss and I feel so offended that she recommended these and that I fell for it. Like she's a ColourPop show. I'm calling it right now. She has a secret motive with them. I'm just kidding. Nisa does not. She's lovely. Go subscribe to her. But like seriously, what's going on? Alright everyone, that's it for me. I'm done yelling for now. This was overhyped makeup. Make sure you go check out all of that merch that I talked about at the beginning of the video. And I know a lot of you have been asking me about the Shane Dawson series. My reaction to part one and part two, which I believe is going live on Friday, will be live on Saturday, so you can get ready for that. If you like this video, please like and subscribe, or just like, or just subscribe, or do neither. Honestly, just so happy you're watching me. Thank you so much for being here. My merch, my social media, and everything I am wearing on my face will be linked down below. Along with, you know it, it's a link to register to vote. That's right. You can go click on that link and be an active participant in your democracy. It's like this cool, fun, awesome thing. I hear you get a free sticker if you do it. So please go register to vote in your local, state, and federal elections. And make sure, just double check that you are actually registered to vote. I've been hearing a lot of people think they are registered and then they end up not being. And if you're not in the United States and that link does not apply to you, make sure you know what's going on. Make sure you're using your voice in a positive way because the world really needs it. I love you guys so much and I will see you in the next one. Bye!